preseason is officially over for the Las Vegas Raiders, ending up 2-1 in the 3 weeks that we had during the preseason. In this video, we're going to break down the last preseason game against the San Francisco 49ers and what is next to come up on Tuesday for the Cuts. Coming right up. Once a Raider, bruh, always a Raider, bruh. Shit, simple as that, you look silver and black. Lot of bread invested in that old line. Car insurance cost an arm and a leg to reach that goat line. Let's go, time. What is going on, Raider Nation? What is going on? It is your boy, Darian, coming to you live with another video. It is the Spotlight Raiders Talk. Shout out to all the subscribers that have subscribed to the YouTube page. If this is your first time ever being at the YouTube page, we do suggest that you subscribe, hit the bell button, and get the latest news in all Raiders news. But we're back here with another video, and we're going to talk about the loss today to the San Francisco 49ers. Understand that it is a preseason game. A lot of our starters did not play. Damn near any of our starters played at all. Most of our starters stayed in Las Vegas instead of going to Santa Clara for this game. So with that being said, we're going to break down this game. We're going to talk a lot about it, and we're going to see who's the winners and who's the losers when it comes to this 53-man roster. So with that being said, let's get straight into the video right now. So with the Las Vegas Raiders having majority of their reserves playing this game for the San Francisco against the San Francisco 49ers, you have to really believe, like, knowing that we already knew coming into this game that the San Francisco 49ers was going to come in with their starters. Now, we all knew that we was going to see a little bit of Jimmy Garoppolo. We all knew we was going to see a little bit of Trey Lance. And we knew that Nathan Peterman was going to be the starter for the Las Vegas Raiders going into this game. Now, we did not have any of our starters on the defensive side of the ball or on the offensive side of the ball. So, with the 49ers playing their starters on both sides of the ball, they really was playing against second and third string type of players. So let's break down this actual game, and let's talk about a little bit when it comes to it. So the Las Vegas Raiders end up losing this game. We all understand that. In my personal opinion, when it comes to it, we all knew the second and third strings was going to play, but we all knew what was going to happen with Trey Lance and Jimmy Garoppolo. And am I satisfied with the preseason? Yes, the Raiders went 2-1 in the preseason, and they went 2-1 in the NFC West, beating the LA Rams and beating the Seattle Seahawks and losing to the San Francisco 49ers. So am I pretty pleased by it? Yes. Is it preseason? Yes, I completely understand that. But at the same time, I have to say, is a few people that I did stand out in this game, and one of those guys was Dylan Stoner. Dylan Stoner was one of those guys that had like 6 receptions, and the guy was very improving. He wanted to make sure that he could make this roster, and Dylan Stoner was one of the guys that was one of my favorites to say, oh, he's going to be a sleeper. He's going to be a surprise person that makes the roster. Now, Amik Robertson did have a great game today against the San Francisco 49ers, knowing that he did play on the outside most of the time when it came to the defense. We all know that Louisiana Amik Robertson was the guy to play outside. So they gave him a chance outside, and he did pretty well. And I have to say this for Damon Arnette as well, knowing that Damon Arnette was a starter last year, but he has been very on a slump when it came to training camp. So when it comes to training camp and when it comes to other games, he did struggle in the preseason. So I do have to commend Damon Arnette for having a great game. It was a make or break game for him to see what is going on with him as far as making this roster. And I think he still will make this roster when it comes to it. Now, on the defensive side of the ball, Gerald McCoy. That defensive line, if you saw Gerald McCoy today, you have to be excited as a Raiders fan, because Gerald McCoy was pushing the line back. He was getting tackles for loss. He was helping out with sacks. Gerald McCoy looks really good coming in wearing that silver and black. And I have to commend Gerald McCoy, missing 2 games already. Missing 2 games already, and now playing in this game, and he showed flashes of his old self when he first came into the league. So Gerald McCoy was another guy that stood out to me as well. Now, on the opposite side of when it comes to the defensive side of the ball, a lot of players did struggle. Tanner Muse, he really struggled in this game with quarterback sneaks, and he didn't recognize it as well. And you have to look at the defensive line. Most of the defensive line really didn't do much, but outside of Gerald McCoy, the linebacking core was not that great. I understand that we need help at the linebacker core, but at the same time, you have to think about it. it wasn't really much that we could do with second and third stringers. Everybody was fighting for a spot here when it comes to that defensive side of the ball. Isaiah Johnson did not play well. He did have two PIs today, two unnecessary PIs today. And Isaiah Johnson has been on the bubble for a long time now when it came to the training camp, because Isaiah Johnson had, we have not seen much from him until today's game, and he didn't play up to the best of his ability, in my opinion. Now, on the offensive side, we all knew that Trey Regis was the guy at running back. It didn't Edmonds, I'm kind of surprised at Edmonds today, that he did give up a fumble in the game, and that really could cost him to see if he makes his practice squad or makes the 53-man roster, which I don't see at all. I don't see that happening when it comes to the offensive side of the ball. Nathan Peterman, he did have a good game with 100, almost 180 yards passing, did have a touchdown, did have an interception. I think it was like 18 of 29. Typical of, you know, Peterman, he's playing with an offensive line that majority of the offensive line probably won't make the team, because that offensive line could not block for him whatsoever. But Dylan Stoner was the standout for me, because I knew Dylan Stoner and DJ Turner was going to be those two guys that go back and forth. But I have to say a standout for Nick Bowers. Nick Bowers was a tight end that came in and gave us the only touchdown that the Raiders have. So with that being said, y'all, I feel as though that the Raiders, they played okay, but at the end of the day, we kind of dominated from all aspects of the game. But this is preseason. This was an evaluation game, and that's what we gave them, an evaluation game. But Raider Nation, let me know what you think. How do you feel about this preseason game? Are you worried going into week one? Because I'm really not worried at all. So comment, like, and subscribe to the channel. It's the Spotlight Raiders Talk. We'll see you in the next live stream or in the next video. Peace. Once a Raider, bruh, always a Raider, bruh. Shit, simple as that, you look silver and black. Lot of bread invested in that O-line. Car insurance cost an arm and a leg to reach that goal line. Let's go.